You have people listening from every corner of this planet. No knowledge has been dispersed so beautifully, so balanced across the planet, on this planet ever. Maybe in the universe. You have the full potential of achieving everything in the universe. There is no need and there is no reason for man not to achieve. So, wherever you are, the way I taught you to make the coils double pole inside, you have continuous equal gravitational magnetic field, and if you put CO2 on it, and you put zinc on it, you have connected the emotion of the man to it on a stable condition, and you'll find out you become a very peaceful man. Here, instead of having galaxies and universes and creating connection magnetically, we have used the matter state gravitational magnetic field strength to dominate and dictate the shape of the plasma. The nano technology, the nanomaterial which you have collectively developed in different ways by caustic, by electric currents, by whatever, fire or whatever, has that advantage that the matter, the nano and the plasma is all the same. So connection is very solid. Is very strong. The power of the plasma technology, the way we have thought, is beyond imagination of the mind. Now you can create and control the plasma, which is the mother of the creation of the universe. You are given the seed of the essence of the creation. The foundation does not belong to no one and is not made of one anymore. You are developing it. You are structuring it. And from today, we will be still the same. We'll still develop the technology in different names, in different colors, in different nationalities, which they do not exist. It is beautiful when we see the Christian, the Muslims, the Jews, and every other belief are working together to build up systems. We have already become one faith. We already have become one nation, and we already become one planet. You got to remember one thing. Dates is irrelevant. Today is the last day of the Christian calendar, or tomorrow is the beginning of another. One day is connected to another. We don't stop. We are working round the clock. The Keshe Foundation team is working irrespective of time, position, religion, country. And now we achieve what we set out for.
The Universal Council invites you to attend the One Planet, One Nation, One Race event in Rome on the 9th and 10th of September 2016. The Council looks forward to open interaction with the public at the event. Come interact with the Council in your spoken language. The Council encourages you to bring your positive suggestions and solutions to the table on how humanity can move forward as a whole towards everlasting peace. In this way, the work of the members of the Council will become the work of humanity for humanity. The full package price for a single ticket to the event includes 3-night stay in one of Rome's prestigious hotels, daily attendance to the event, as well as breakfast on the 9th through the 11th, and lunch and tea on the 9th and 10th. Accommodations for this package is based on double occupancy. The full package price for 2 tickets to the event includes 3-night stay in a twin bed room in one of Rome's prestigious hotels, daily attendance to the event, as well as breakfast on the 9th through the 11th, and lunch and tea on the 9th and 10th. Additional night stay are offered at €150 per person per night. For those who wish to arrange their own accommodations and who plan on attending a single day of the event, the cost will be €200, which includes tea and lunch on the day of the event. For those who wish to arrange their own accommodations and who plan on attending both days of the event, the cost will be €300, which includes tea and lunch on the day of the event. The One Planet, One Nation, One Race event in Rome. Come share your positive solutions on how we can work together to bring everlasting peace to our world.
Okay. Welcome, everyone. Welcome to the 16th International Knowledge Seekers Workshop of the Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute for May 24th, 2016. I'm Rick Crammond, your host, and I think Mr. Keshe is waiting in the wings here, ready to go with presenting what's going on in the world of the international scene for the Keshe Foundation. Go ahead, Mr. Keshe.
Italians who are listening to the teachings on the international side. On Thursday of this week, most probably by Thursday, we will announce the bank which will release the finances for the €10 per month for the power unit. The Magra power unit will be put in with a bank facility available. When you walk to the bank, you just give a code and you fill in the form and the finances will be available for purchasing the Magrav units. The condition is slightly different. It's the way it's been set up by the bank structure, where you receive the Magrav unit plus the pen pads and energized system, or you're given a second option to cover what the banking system has allowed us to do. On the other hand, you can go directly to the Keshe Foundation website and purchase the system directly. the whole structure of the delivery of the power units in Italy is based on financed by the bank that we can deliver the units into Italy only. As I said, we cannot use this facility, but most probably in next 2 weeks we allow German banking system too. The same in Austria and France. We are extending the coverage by where you can buy the units in Germany, in France and in Austria at about the same price of 10 euro per month payment. Possibly we can add a couple of more nations. Spain and Portugal might come under the same cover. It depends how we negotiate with the banking structure, but we'll know sometime today. By Thursday, we might announce the coverage on all the banks in all the countries by end of this month, then, which is allowing us to produce and deliver initially as we are doing in Italy, hopefully in two more European countries, and then we go to other part of the world. Do we have anything to show, or are we going on a teaching direct today, Rick? Are there anybody who wants to share knowledge with us? Anything you developed or you want to share knowledge? We give you the floor, otherwise we go on to teaching.
Okay, well, we can look, we can see if there's any people in the viewers that have something to contribute today to the international teaching, or somebody that's just been promoted to panelists. There was a couple of people with their hands up. I'm not sure if they wanted to present or whether they had questions for later or just wanted to record. Anybody who's a viewer that has something they'd like to present, they can put their hand up and I can recognize you and promote you to a panelist where you can speak. And do we have anyone out there that has anything for today? Going once, going twice. I guess you're up, Mr. Keshe, for teaching.
I prefer to teach.
I think we're ready to listen, perhaps.
Okay. Part of the teaching, what we want to carry on with the development, is just following our private teaching this morning, because a large number of the students in the morning join us in the afternoon and the other sessions. We are teaching and going further with the development of the technology. As I explained, a number of scientific groups, a number of countries have got further involved in development of the technology in achieving lift and achieving the structure. In this process that we have come to understanding of the production of gravitational magnetic field systems, man has entered a new dimension, which is the what we will concentrate in the next coming few days or teachings, which has got to be part of the structure of the teaching in how to survive into space. In so many ways, we have learned how to survive on this planet, and we have evolved and matured. We have changed colors from black to white to yellow. We have narrowed our eyes and we have widened our eyes. We changed the color to blue and yellow and black and any other color which we like. We have found ways to survive. This is not talking about the man only, but we're talking about the entire life on this planet. Life on this planet has changed drastically from the inception as we have evolved. We have chosen hair, some chosen feather, some has chosen different ways of protecting the GAN system of our body. Some have decided to cover it with a matter state that allows the interface between the matter and the GAN's body of the man in different shape and forms. But what's going to happen to man now that we open the space? Now that we enter the dimension of a slightly different environment than we are used to. We have had excursions into space, but we have covered ourselves with all kind of clothing, masks and whatever we could. What happens now that become the passengers of the space, and most probably one kind of suiting is fits, but not to all the environments. And as we stay in space for long durations, where home is not the earth, but the space becomes the home of the man, how do we evolve? What is the next steps of evolution of the man in the space? How do we interact with the creatures of the space? What are the rules? What are the red traffic lights and what is green? How do we understand what is green to us is not red to the others? The process of the teaching is moving into the steps of the interaction with the universal community. No more with what we do on this planet, because we have brought you to the point that from now on is your decision, is the way the governments, the nations, the individuals decide to go to the step to move on, to develop, to create the environment and the condition of, doesn't matter whatever you call it, the spaceship, a carrier of human beings, a container, whatever you want to call it. But in a space we can't stay in a box, and we cannot confine ourselves into a closed environment for centuries and thousands of years. We will put out, we will interact, we will come across other creations and creatures of the universe. Do we understand all the same language? What do we need to do? As I said in the teaching this morning, what is the consequences of if you are the last man standing in space? Do you know enough to survive? Or do you know the rules of the space to survive? This is where the teachings from now on will go. And in so many ways, the international teaching changes into universal teaching. Maybe that's the reason we have no questions and no one to show. In time, we'll merge the two. As I said before, when the man matures enough, we will bring those who you've been longing to see and talk to for a long time, creatures of the space. But you have to understand, it will not be the zoo as you go and you poke and look at the animals inside the cage. You got to understand, the man has been an animal in the cage of the planet Earth and has been looked into by the others. How do we expand the knowledge of the man? How do we bring man to the point that he understands now the foot and the shoe have to fit in every corner of this universe? Do we need governments? As the governments will negotiate for their own population with one group of what you call passengers of the universe, and other governments negotiate different things? Or do we choose the path which is set up by the Foundation? We negotiate as one race, one planet, one nation. The teachings from now on will head to that way, to make man a unified family. It'll be very hard for those who are racist, does not matter if it's a color, the race, or whatever. The whole problem is, do we understand the language of the universal community? Or would we go through the harsh way, the way the human race has gone, in fighting with ourselves to negotiate, to get the better deal for us to be equal outside? We have no choice. The choice is where we have brought our race to today, at this point and this moment. We have decided to create division for whatever reasons, and we have launched and we have supported divisions because it benefited or suited us for for whatever reason, school of thoughts, financially, position-wise, or for whatever reason, background. As I said, we will show what has been your dream. We'll bring you to the condition that you develop the technology and the knowledge and the know-how to be able to interact with the universal community. But would all the human race will behave the same? As we know, a number of nations have already established links. Might be surprising to a lot of you, but some of you might think that's another talk. Leading world nations have already established the link in communication, but still they do not know how to communicate. But what is the structure? How can we establish a structure where us as one nation can negotiate or can communicate that we understand the totality of the structure? As I said, this is the way, as I explained this morning to our knowledge seekers as students, the same. We try to teach from now on the universal community work, understanding, interaction, and understanding our own failures. It's us who has to polish this act. It's us who has to come to understand we kept ourselves isolated because of our behavior. How do we interact? How do we build the systems? How do we build structures that it is usable to us? Doesn't matter if it's social structure or whatever shape or form in the universe. But we represent the, what I call, or what you like to call, the intelligent race of this planet. But let us ask ourselves a very good question. How intelligent this intelligent animal has been? How far and what have we left behind? Have we created the most of the division that now we're trying to find a solution for? And would we follow the same process and make the same mistakes in the time to come? The problem is very deep, extremely deep. And to change the culture of man after so many years of conflict, separation, division, for whatever reason, color, race, language, imaginary line of what you call borders, are we allowed or do we allow this to happen? Are we going to allow this division that has created so much mayhem to carry on that benefits a few but creates harm for the others? In the coming time, we have started the process. We establish an army of peace, which means leading world governments will participate only in peace work, which means they promote one thing, and that is the work to create peace, create forces, what you call military, in the direction of creation of peace, and in a way to be able to understand the totality, to set examples that we can follow. This is very harsh. Even nowadays, even today standing here, for us, people who have the tools, the followers of the Keshe Foundation, in decontamination, in eradication of whatever contamination and damage we've done to our planet, is a big question. Even we show it, it has created them problem. We had a meeting with a professor yesterday here in the center from one of the leading universities. And I said to him, and he said, yes, you're right. I said, Keshe Foundation have many enemies. Our enemies more or less becoming more and more talkative, because the more they realize, we are touching everything. Everything which has been wrong, we can put right, it endangers them. It's not for them, because look in what you're doing. Understand how your work has brought so many changes. And these changes are not good for those who've been benefiting by the wrongdoing. We touch energy. This is the biggest problem for them. We touch food. We touch agriculture. We touch medicine. We touch materials. And what is the most fearful to us is the space technology. With energy, with the Maglev units you produce in any shape or form, you stack them together, you use them separately, you put them in the GANs, you're touching the what we call energy producing nations. They don't like it. So we have created huge number of enemies on the energy side. You've seen more and more of opposition in all shape or forms, because now it's a big problem. Energy should not be a commodity to create wealth and control. For those who have been used to, for example, in the oil industry, for hundreds of dollars per barrel, what comes naturally, created on a daily basis across this planet, or creation of nuclear power stations, paid billions and billions, not only for commissioning them, more for decommissioning them. Interesting point of view is now that number of nations have started decommissioning nuclear reactors. Why? Suddenly out of nowhere. Because now it's more profitable to decommission than build nuclear reactors. More money is in it, so they are in it. We touch the food. The food industry is going to go beyond belief and understanding how much everyday shopping, it comes to more or less an end. Shop for food. Now, you are producing the GANs, which become the energy source for man to live on. Agriculture, we've seen the control on the seed, is finished. You come into medical application, we've seen how doctors are reporting changes using Maglev systems and others. And the space technology is where the foundation work is more acceptable than anything else, because in reality, man has not managed to do much in the space. We have limited what are called fish tanks, and even a few have become the passengers. Now the space is in your hand, but to open the space is the biggest challenge for the foundation, because your work has two dimensions. One, we have to bring the nations together to work together, because there is no borders. You cannot detect, you cannot see, you cannot stop. Secondly is your biggest problem. Man needs what are called certificate, or the understanding of the work of the universal order, which means you have to become peaceful. You have to change the behavior of the man in the space. How do we do this? How do we change the characteristics? How do we go about? We have shown a number of ways to create this elusive peace. We try through conferences to bring nations in parallel. We try through technology delivery. And we try through the food to change the habit of the planet. The space technology from now on is in one direction. How do we create a plasma, which this plasma will give what we need? do we create a condition through the plasma's interactions with other plasmas to create motion? Do we create field releases from the same interaction to create food? Or do we create a condition which touches the emotion of the man, which brings peace on this planet and every other animal? We have two choices in that regard. Man finds peace in two ways. So do the animal. When there is no need to fight for resources or energy to stay warm, to stay fed, to have a shelter. In that regard, one of the leading nations has taken a step in the coming past few days to create the Oasis system in mass production. I thank you for your work. You're on the panel. We know you're listening. And we support you fully. Yes. You want to change me?
That is something extremely
about something.
No, it's
rubbing. It's rubbing? Is it too low or too high?
No, you want to go there?
You're always too sensitive, it's like me. Talking about the microphone. So the position is that some governments, some people have decided to go for what we call the Oasis system in a huge production. But what is the outcome if we create this Oasis system, but we do not create Oasis on this planet? We've seen interruptions, we've seen disruption, but in totality, are we going to support, or as Keshe Foundation, we become one to support in one direction, to develop systems as the majority decide that we think it brings peace on this planet. But we have other choice. There is another option. We have seen the process, the working, and the operation of materials which you produce as GANs, to, as we've seen from people in Vienna, putting systems that people will receive enough energy that satisfies the emotion of the man to become peaceful. Do we deposit huge amount of GANs waters, or we set up traps in the oceans and the rivers where the GANs water mixes with the river to cleanse them, to deplete them, and at the same time, in that process, allows the animals, the fish or whatever, to receive the energy they need to survive, to not to eat each other, but to take energy from the planet direct. The number of people who are testing this, is this an option for us to go? Or do we go in the other hand, on the other way, and plan systems like satellites, which feed us internationally equal? Don't forget the satellites in the sky, which send you your communication line, the telephone lines, and the radiation from these satellites passes through all of us, unless it finds its matching target. It's not that it only looks for it, it spreads it, and it finds it. Do we come, or have we come to the point that we can rely on governments like Chinese government to create these kind of satellites, to put above cities and countries that can feed the need of the man, with it, the animal, and the fish, and the rest? This is a very viable proposition. This is exactly what you have created as Maghreb system. you can extend the power of the magnetic system, especially with liquid plasma and the field plasma, to cover vast areas of this planet. The way we receive the rays of the sun, now we control the rays, which brings peace, it brings tranquility, it feeds man for everything he needs. There is a very interesting point about this. I was discussing this with the governments very recently. But then we can control people through these systems too. The answer is no. There is no way you can control this, because as you create a magnetic system, only it matches what it needs. You cannot give it to it to encourage one or the other. Can we control the emotion of the planet? Not really, because emotion sits at the level which a man's knowledge at this moment cannot reach to control. Can we come to the point where we can interfere with what the body needs? Yes, emotionally you can build up to the point what the need is, but you cannot interfere with it to control it. So, how do we do this? How can we control this? There are systems which are in the process of being built. You can build it yourself. Try to understand the work of the system. You have systems, a lot of you have built the coil system with a center. And then you have built the coils around it, where you have fed and you filled up with the GANs. Now you are in the process of rotating these two in, could be any direction, individually or at the same time in the same direction. What you put as a source, you can feed from outside. And this, as a field, can cover more or less, if you look on a satellite point of view, a whole continent. This is what we are targeting in, and you understand there is a different application for this. This is your ball in the center of your magnetic system. These are your double coils. And in so many ways, you decide what radiates out. Antibiotics, vitamin C, orange juice, or whatever. In a way, we take one of the biggest problems for man out of the control of the man, but in his freedom to have as a pleasure for man, which is feeding him. Would any of us will go to the fields, or any of us will go hungry? That will not be the case. We take, as they said up to now, there's going to be a war on energy and water. But if you understand the use of this system, you don't have to worry about the water, because the water we need to guarantee our life, which we live by the rivers and the cities where there could be a pipe, we can transfer the energy of the water that the body of the man takes as he likes. The way as you've done with the food, the way you did with the orange, the way you did with herbs. So, the equation of the water, man depending to live in one certain local positions, goes out of the window. These are the solutions, these are peaceful solutions, which now with this technology is available to stop the cause of many wars, which has been behind a lot of things. The other one is energy. If you can transfer, and you understand how to transfer energy at this rate, using the same technology, every man can have light and heating as he likes. The Innovation Center in Philippines and other people who support it and work around it already are in, as you heard before, 3 meters or so wireless transmission of energy. We will come to full dimension across this planet, maybe I think in another 6 weeks, 10 weeks. I do not teach, I just support, and every now and then I put a suggestion in and we see how we go. So these are what we heard in that beautiful tape about the Rome Conference. Come in with a practical, peaceful, positive solution. 3 members of the council who stood in Dubai have been rejected from the council, and they will not receive invitation because they carried with the same habit of before in destruction, are more superior, and lying and cheating. And we see in the process. If you become part of using this system, it means you have to be peaceful. It means you come on board to bring solutions which advances man towards a peace, towards application of the technology for peace process. So, what are the other solutions? The teachings from now on is to enhance intellect in the direction of the peace. Enhance for you to come up with the solutions. How and the way you see it can help humanity. It can help the total structure. We've seen the situation, as I explained before, with copper oxide liquid gas or liquid plasma. Yes, it destroys everything, but are we allowed to destroy everything? Or we create a condition that everything exists, coexists with each other, that both have opportunity to live according to their environment. If we create damage environmentally, unknowingly, or for whatever reason, the mistakes of the past or the benefits that now become the mistake, we have a solution to find in a positive way through this technology. It is to set the standard of finding solution without damaging more or changing to benefit one to overcome the others. In the coming week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, the foundation will announce collaboration with a number of organizations around the world. To be it on the water, be it on food, be it on peace, be it on application of the delivery of what to you is called spaceship. Come in with a positive understanding and understand that all the knowledge is on the table. As I said, in the coming weeks I'll stop teaching because I have thought and I brought man to the point that the man has to decide for himself. And everything from then on, it goes to the Universal Council for them to start the process to find a solution for everything that only leads to one thing. Not only peace for human race, but the peace for this planet and all its creatures. Because we cannot be at peace when we don't create a comfort zone for everything else which exists amongst us. The process of interaction of the plasma is a backbone of understanding of the technology. Try to understand how the plasma works, what is the plasma, how you reach it, and then look at it in a very simple pace. You have the copper or the zinc, you have changed atomic structure of system being tightly packed to each other in a molecule, what you call solid matter, to the spacing of what we call monoatomic, or what is famous nowadays as nanotechnology. It rains from it in a rare condition, what you call the gases, when they are free. And now we have brought the technology to the step, the fields of these without themselves. That in totality what rains, it becomes whatever you need to make from it. From any state of the matter to any state of liquid or a gas, as it suits you. This is the option you have in the universe. This is what has been given, and now we have to use not this, but this. The interaction of the fields, what we want to create from them, what we expect from them, because you can have everything you need from whatever material you use. You use CO2, you still end up with a field. You use copper oxide, you still end up with a field. You use CH3, it's the same. You use copper, zinc, or whatever. At the end, you end up with a field. In a way, we have to learn about the soup of the fields which we make from materials to create a condition that it brings peace to us, it brings balance in our accepting equality for the whole occupants of this vehicle we call planet Earth. None of us is wrong, and none of us is 100% right. But the setting up the Universal Council and the people who start working around the humanitarian kind will find a beautiful time. Because you don't talk about the peace, you don't talk about what can we bring. Now the tool of peace is in your hand, you decide the decision. Some of the world leaders have already decided. We salute you. In the coming time, you will see them. But this field brings you to your new headache. And your new headache is not peace on this planet. It's peace and interaction with the universal community. This is what we have to understand. How and the way you will react with universal community. We have to put our house in order before we can do outside. We have to clean up this mess here before we go to the next step. A lot of people ask a very simple question. It cannot be done, but we can do our best. It can be done, and we are doing our best. How can we overcome multi-million organizations? Nothing. You change the thinking and the thought of the man who sits behind it. I was just telling Giovanni, just beginning of this teaching a few minutes ago, one of the richest men in one of the countries around the world has got a cancer. We have a number of them do. And strange enough is that these rich men with all their wealth, they cannot find solution for the problem. And they're turning into Keshe Foundation to see if there is a solution for them. Even the religious leaders which you see and you worship, they have turned in the past and current time to the foundation for the solution for physical ailment. But they don't want to go any further. It's good for them to receive the systems, to for them to physically be able to be in public domain, but they will not tell you what they use and how they use and what they received from the foundation. One of the most famous religious leaders that has the most populated support has been using the system of Keshe Foundation since last November. It was built here in Valletta for him. The people who were involved are listening to the teaching. but can we go to them and ask them for the support to bring peace according to us? You have to understand, the biggest problem for the Foundation is the religious organizations, because by bringing peace, unifying the religions, there is no place for them to live. Because when we are all one, do we need religious leaders to tell us? So in a way, we are a poison chalice. Don't drink it or drink it. Either way, you come to the point that when we are unified, there is no need for the division. So how do we do this? How do we go to the next step? We need to create plasma systems which have two functions. They interact with the emotion of the man. And we all know zinc is one of them. We need to interact with a structure of balance keeping within the structure of the amino acid, which is the backbone of the life on this planet. Phosphor. We need to interact with the RNA of the memory of the whole backbone. We need to interact the way the physicality of being on this planet have been controlled. Through its emotion. We need to interact with a system which allows the transfer of energy from one to another. Sulfur. We need to create a system which allows any extra field which is in the environment, given or produced and not wanted, to be taken out. Options two. Lead or gold. So we need to find a system which does all this, but we need a system which allows a free energy development in the space of the amino acid of the man, which is the best companion of this. Then you have to find a system which connects the totality in the information transfer with the cell of the man, the carbon. The system has to be, one, balances the emotion. Second one, balance the physicality. The third one brings energy that can support the other two, and you need a line of connection. Now you can see how those number ones can be filled in. You need to make a GANS liquid that allows you to use such a mixture in totality to fit into the structure of life with deviation of Cu or magnesium. You got to understand the connection between the structure, that we don't rely on the matter, but this in totality creates a field that each one of us take from it what we need. The new GAN systems has to be according to the condition and the environment of this planet. That's why we are the children of this planet. Doesn't matter if you're a tree, a dog, a human being or a fish. We are all the children of this planet. We are created by it, it has nourished us, it has brought us the condition to exist. So, for us to exist in the universe, and for us to be in a peaceful condition, we have to create that atmosphere constantly anywhere in the universe. And then, on top of it, you have to superimpose the condition of the destination or the environment which you have entered. In so many ways, now you need to create a condition where the field's interaction brings the condition. And the condition is dictated by the interaction of the total field of all the entities which creates the whole structure of the man. Any of the materials missing will doom the man because there'll be a shortage. You withdraw the zinc, you have a bunch of crazy people traveling because the emotion is not satisfied. You don't put iron, you cannot feed the essence of the creation of the man itself, which is his blood. And then hydrogen. Then you have other entities, but you have covered yourself with a gold and silver, which means with the presence of sulfur and the presence of what you call lead, you have created the zinc, but you have created a condition of division from one element to another. Don't forget, the sulfur is the balancer. What you're short of is the habit of sulfur to be able to convert, to give when it's needed and to take when it's not needed. So it allows conversion of the material from one to another as needed. And you'll come to understand very soon, sulfur plays a huge role in the body of the man to fulfill any shortages between these three. And it's the same with magnesium when it comes to vertical and horizontal people. You need the phosphorus for guaranteeing the solidarity and the energy balance of the recording section of the body of the man without tangibility, which is in fact your RNA. And the backbone of the interaction of RNA with DNA. The bridge between the DNA and RNA is phosphorus. And there is no other way. That's why the phosphorus is seen in physicality in DNA as a spacing, and its energy is a controller of the distance for your RNA. And that's what we call magnetic gravitational positioning. You need to create such a structure in your system. Then you'll find out the system will work perfect enough for man in this space. Understand the reason why you use these GANSes, why you allow these filterings, why you create a condition of the interaction of the field. as I said, and I keep on saying, the teaching will go very fast, but it's so deep that a lot of people don't understand it, unless you're specialized in one way or another. But we are teaching for totality, for what some of you might pick up, add to, and increase. You can create very much a direction and a position of, for example, communication between the whole system. Does not matter where you are, instant communication, simply by you understanding the work of this little child. You attract and you interact and hold the human body with its gravitational system on the other side to oxygen, on the atmospheric condition of this planet. Now you see all the teachings, all of the making the GANs and all of the making of the nanomaterials come together. You put nano of gold and copper bunches up to a very little dust. You made it into a GANs, you have increased its power and its range, you have made it into liquid, you have taken other physical, but only its energy. So this is what you need to do. And then the change comes in how, in what percentage of which we have added to the system. You want a peaceful man in emotion, you make sure you have as much possible on this range. You want to get aggression out of man, you reduce this. You want to detach man from physicality, you play with this. You want to bring plants in line with a man to understand, you play with this. Then you understand how you change the whole structure. Now man, what we call humanity, has become the king of the animals, because the job of a king is to look after all his subjects. And when you are the king of the planet, as you call yourself, then you're responsible for everything. From the fish to the tree, from the amoeba to a lion and a tiger and an elephant. And it has to be in a correct way. It has to be in a way that they choose the path, not enforced on. The process of taking and understanding this will take time. We've been doing what we are doing for thousands of years, and it will not change. It's not very easy to tell people you cannot kill. We become so fantastic in killing and justifying it that we have created armies for killing. We have become worse than the animals, the ants and the rest. This is how low the humanity has got to. We have created tools to kill each other in mass, and we have justified it by nations, religion, color or race. We are more or less the only creatures of the universe which plans, dictates and spends time and energy in how to kill each other. Shame on being human race. Why? We see killing as a path for us to be in control or in charge of, for us to be the head of. I think in so many ways, when you get to that point, you have become the lowest animal on this planet. How can you call yourself the king of the planet, the king of the animals? Because the only thing which left, you're lower than animals. Animals don't do what the man does, killing himself and his own race. The whole process will take time, but the whole process, as we've seen, does not need time. We've seen our doctors that they report to us, they have changed the cancer in 3 days and 5 days and 10 days using the MagRaf systems, the coils and the rest. That is the change of physicality. So if Keshe Foundation decides, as you are the foundation, to bring peace, does not take much. We have put you through phases of doing different ways, building different things. Now you have the acceptance, the knowledge of producing a system which can satisfy all the needs of the man, irrespective of emotion, physical and the rest. We are running trials for different applications of the technology. I was walking a couple of days ago and I saw a handicapped child due to whatever defects. We give them different names for different mishaps in genetic or taking off the air at the point of the earth or whatever at the point of birth. What about if we put these people through the MagRaf system? Would we see the changes? And if we do, which we do, we know it has been done. Would it be not the time that different Keshe Foundations around the world, different supporters, produce the same systems and just run it through the GANs? Make a standard mixture that it fits the humanity and the rest of the creatures on this planet. Then we can see the changes. Then the time is for a change. Then when we do not think, we do not carry, we do not initiate wars through non-existence of conflict within ourselves, within our structure of amino acid, then we will not change the mind. In medical application, we show systems which you put on either side of the body and you transfer energy to bring balance. Would putting satellites, would putting ships on the waters, or putting systems in the cities, will bring the fields to connect from one side of the planet to another, that the man will go through the change? Most probably yes. It's been done before and it works. And then, when we come to this point, when we have this mixture, what I call the peace mixture, peace for humanity, peace for planet on this earth, then you find out what is not needed is given to those which they need, and the system finds a balance in what it receives and what it gives. The biggest problem in the any kind of race, the fish, the man, the animals here, is the high energy released between the amino acid and iron. Wood development of the technology like this will bring the balance of the fields, which changes the emotional behavior of the man. The more we consume iron based food, the more animal instinct raises, the more aggression raises in man. Our face changes, our behavior changes. Would that be the same if we can create a condition when we bring a balance, we still eat whatever you eat, but we can place a system which takes the energy more from iron and gives it to other points, or allows it to be converted in the same mixture by phosphor or sulfur. The tool of peace is in the hand of the man for the first time, not by talking, but by delivering. And the beauty of it is, once you make this mixture in a gaseous state, all you need to do is spread the water across the world. You can pour it in the oceans, you can spread across, you can run it in the motors and the cores and the coils, anywhere you like. The interesting point will be, how much is man committed to peace? And how much man is committed to unity of the race on this planet? Those who will object launching of systems like this, you intrude my privacy, it means I want to carry on with abuse. Let's see how many people object, and then we'll see the true face of the abusers. The opposition comes from those who want to carry on with abuse. The collaboration comes from those who want to see the change. This is a peace mixture, in a way, by balancing all the energies within the body of the man, that man finds peace within himself, because he receives everything he needs, and through the right structure, gives what he doesn't need and takes what he needs. You have the carbon on one side, and you have the oxygen on the other side. If you look in all of it, you take a lot, but you give a very little, but in giving very little, you convert it to what little the others need in all your system. A giver, take. All the rest is all the same. We take a lot, but we use it in line of sharing and in a kind of giving. There are a couple of more elements which you can add to this. And in a way, you create and then start the process of peace without the man knowing. We've seen people putting systems around Vienna. But if you put a system around, at least make the right mixture. Satisfy the need of the man. Even with the gold oxide, you satisfy the man hunger for wealth. It's amazing, because he feels rich, he has the gold, but he has no gold with him. This is the solution without any single bullet. This is a peace solution. Up to now, you could not have it, because you could not see the path where you're going, what's going to happen. Now that the number of nations have started the process of launching the Keshe Foundation programs for Oasis system and space and control of energy systems, now you can all have the same. We still carry on building systems, we still carry on doing systems, but this is a peace recipe which man cannot ignore. And in the coming time, we have a very nice plan for you. Without you knowing it, you'll be manufacturing it, you'll be using it, you'll be launching it, and in a very short time, next 6 to 12 months, no one will touch if they understand the process, a point of aggression. We don't go to fight, we deliver the tool of the peace. You know, in so many ways, we always use the tool of the man to get to what the man needs in this technology. A lot of you have gold chains and silver chains. A lot of you have copper wires and you have iron wires. All the tool of the peace sits with you at home. Somebody asked us, how do you make silver GANs? How do you make gold GANs? We would like to make it. Now, I can teach you my way, or we can teach you other ways. Go back to understanding of the top, where we started. You have atomic structure. You have to loosen it, not by heating, but by field interaction. You use caustic. If you go back to the beginning, we always connected your plates to a current flow with another plate. Let's do it here. So, the current flow between the two plates has, let's do it this way, maybe you understand better. If you put another plate here, the current flow between the two plates has a direct effect on how you loosen after the heating or with the heating. One of the reasons we connect to power supply, or we put an LED to create a potential difference, is to allow, once it's loosened, to become atomically positioned. So, you can use both the caustic and the current flow. Then, you can use the same process in a very slow current flow, once you loosen it, to create any gas you like, irrespective of the material. You've seen it, and we explained many times, how we produce massive amount of copper oxide for the gas units, for the magma units. We connect our copper plates to the electricity, and instead of NaOH, we use salt. That's what you do. You put your plates in salt water, you create a GANs. But you can produce and use a combination of the two to create GANs of any material. Some of you understood this, and some of you didn't. Some of you have seen this from the beginning in the Coca-Cola bottle. Don't forget, one of the easiest way to release energy at the present time, which is at the reach of every one of you, is anything based on CH, which is 80% of the plastics. One of the best way to release energy in a liquid state that it can add or release its power is the glue guns. This is why in all the systems which are manufactured for years for the health system, if you open it up, you'll find the glue which glues the glue gun to the system. Because at a point of the heat at a special high temperature, you release the energy which with the gas you put into it, traps the energy to feed it. That's how, this is another secret which I never released in my technology in the health application. You've seen it when I brought it, when we opened up in Trani last year, we showed the system. You see a glue paste. I glue in a hidden way the GANs, but I use at the high temperature to release its energy to be used by the system. Because that's the easiest way. It's like you drinking sugar. What do? You take huge amount of energy, but you have to create a condition for the energy to be at a high level of release that it can lock into the GANs, into the nanomaterials, that it can release its energy at a constant base. If you look, I can bring you a few more systems from downstairs in the lab, where we put the magnets to confirm the direction of the flow on the, for example, the water containers. You see a very low GANs, totally non-detectable, and then you see a magnet which is surrounded with stuck to with hot glue. The interaction of the two creates a special connection of the field which is there feeding it, with a hole inside the magnet, you literally gun it into what you want to do. You use solid magnet, you spread the field. Now you have the plates which you have not yet learned how to use them, and the coils. It's the same process. In part of the health, which a lot of you are working on, there is a very simple system that replicates, and none of you have done up to now. I use both solid magnet and the ring magnet. A ring magnet is to keeping a spread of the field. For the ring magnet is to target. So those of you, for example, who make the health units, now you can add to your knowledge in another way. Where you made your coils in your panels, you can use the other side copper plates, zinc plates, nano-coated. So you target. These, up to now, you use these systems only with, and then you can GANs code section by section the way you want. Don't forget, those of you who are doctors and work on the health section, you use these GANs codes with CO2 plus zinc plus CH3. And if you place it, if you place this plate at the ring, at the end of the amputation, you will see miracles of the growth of the arm, leg, toe, or whatever you wish, because you have created the energy of the tissue, you have added the emotion, and you have given the energy to call upon. Long time I've been telling you, we release the discs of nano-coated for the hospitals and doctors who face amputation. Costs less than a few cents. But at the same time, the presence of the copper on the plate guarantees 100%, 100%, no infection. Distance 2 to 3 millimeters, no more. You need to have the combination of the two. The information carried from the neural system and from the what we call the blood will be responded to by any of the three interactions. You can add to this phosphor, you can add to this sulfur, you can add to this in a very, very fine way chlor. You find out, if you get it the right way, and you can do it in the right shape and condition, you should get an increase of, let's say, a finger or a toe by millimeters in a short time. Because the body does not see the end, the body sees a continuation. So, the organs, the pieces, will keep on growing. If you do the same, for example, the reverse of this, where you create a condition of the balance, you can target into the center of a tumor and create a reversal. The same process can be done for growing heart tissues, where there is a heart damage into the fiber of the muscles of the tissue of the heart. You can grow, if you understand this system and target it, you can build up valves which are damaged. There is no need for open heart surgeries. But you have to understand how it's done and the way it's done. It needs a total understanding of the world of medicine. Now you see it's a very simple ways. If you understand the technology in a true sense of it, if you're the last man standing in a space, you will survive for thousands of years till you decide, I would like to make an Adam or Eve to have companion. Because then, if you have the knowledge and you understand it the correct way, it's at your will and your wish. Because when you allow that, it means you don't give from the physicality, but you give from the soul as well. And that is the true man. That's the true being in being able to give. This is what the Christ did, bless his name. We see the resurrection of the dead. He gave from his soul, and in giving from the soul, raised the soul of the man, which the raising of the soul gives life, or the soul is dictator of the physicality, and the physicality walks. So it's the same way. If you understand this, and you're the last man standing, then you'll be the last man, because you can always create a partner. Then you pass the point of sharing of the soul. And this may answer those who say, what does the soul mate mean? Soul mate knows no space, no time in the universe, as it's created out of you, by you, for the existence, confirmation of your own existence, not to be alone in space of the universe. So the man can do the same. So it goes back to the story. Is there any truth about the Adam and Eve and the rib? Or is the rib is so close to the heart, and the heart connected to the emotion, and the emotion is the feeding of the soul? But the man could not understand what the soul meant when he was told the story of Adam and Eve. Are there any questions?
Thank you, Mr. Keshe. Questions from our panelists, or if there's any participants that would like to ask a question, they can put up their hand and I can promote you to a panelist. There are a couple of questions in the Q&A, but not quite sure how related it is, but Colleen mentions, Mr. Keshe, there are small orbs of GANs forming in a gold GANs fountain that I made. Can you please explain a reason for this or what this is? They look like small fluffy pearls. I do have photos if you would like to see them.
Yes.
This from Colleen. Okay, Colleen, if you can bring up those pictures. See, let's get you into the panelists. Is there anyone else that would like to line something up here after Colleen? Get in line. Okay, Colleen, I think your mic is open there now. Maybe she still needs to see. Can you speak there, Colleen? Not hearing you yet, but your mic is open. She says her mic is not working. Okay, she's sending the pictures. I believe she's sending them to me, so I might have to look at them a bit differently, let's say. Okay, let me get that set up. In the meantime, is there somebody else that has a question for Mr. Keshe? Is everyone sort of dumbfounded here? Let's not be shy.
Have you got the pictures?
Not coming up with them yet. I'm trying to see how they might be sent. She's going to try sending them to my email. Let's see, maybe there's another way. Okay, I think I see on her Facebook there's a picture. Okay, this is it, I guess, so let me get that zeroed in. Okay, Colleen, I'll use your pictures from the Facebook here, I guess. Let's have a look at that. I think you should be able to see that up there. Get the right one. There, I think that's the picture of the pearl and the other material that she's talking about there. Can you see that, Mr. Kish?
No.
Oh. Maybe the screen share is not working.
Yeah, it's on the panel, I guess.
Oh, okay. It's just hard to see, I guess. Maybe I can blow it up a bit. No, I can't do that. Have to download the picture in order to properly look at it. Okay, I've got I can blow it up better here now. Share.
It still becomes its own canvas.
I can't see what it is.
Yeah.
Can you?
I'll not wait.
Okay, so let me see if we have any comments here.
I don't see what it is.
Well, you can see the sort of pearl in the center of the oyster shell there.
Yeah.
And I think this other ball substance here as well. This formed apparently in her system. Unfortunately, her microphone is not working.
What it is, I don't understand what she's done.
Yeah, unfortunately the microphone's not working, but perhaps just a second here, maybe I can get something from the...
Is that a shell inside the shell? A pearl shell?
Yeah, it's a pearl that's sitting in the oyster shell. But it's not really a pearl, it's some sort of round ball. She says it's more fluffy than hard. And I don't know much more about it other than that. It was posted in the, I think it was in the Golden Age of GANs as well. Maybe I can find out more there. Unfortunately, her microphone's not working right now, so it's hard to describe, I guess.
Come back next time and explain.
Okay, that would be a good idea. Okay, what else do we have to show?
As I said this morning in the teachings, one of the Keshe Foundations have managed to create creatures for existence, life. He has blood. He has a... what do you call it? Like a soft, hard shell, very much like transparent when you take an eggshell and you take the shell off, you see that membrane, and in moving it, he burst in one place and he was bleeding and he was so sorry that he hurt the animal or the being, whatever he created. As I said, we are entering into the dimension where people are creating new structures, life structures, and the beauty is to have respect for it and what they do and what they grow, how they grow. It's
speaking of life structures, we do have John Bivin from the Arizona manufacturing that has some sort of report that he can give. That could be interesting. Would you like to go there, Mr. Keshe? Or?
Yes, yes.
Okay, John?
Can you hear me?
Yes, hi.
Hi, John.
Hi. Can I show some pictures of some of the stuff that we're doing?
Sure, please do.
You say international teaching and you're part of the foundation.
Okay, let's see what I can do.
I hear you're going to have visitors soon, John.
I'm waiting, yeah.
You might have a new visitor. Have you had a lot of demonstrators outside?
No.
That's what they're asking everybody to go and disturb as much as possible. I wondered how many free units you've given up to now to all these demonstrators.
We operate on peace. And somehow, when we operate on peace, the trouble doesn't find us.
No, because I've seen that they put everybody in it, block their telephones and go there and demonstrate and write to the internet people. This is a fraudulent, what do you call it? Monsters and the rest of it. I wanted to know how much the publicity has helped you.
We're doing good.
Have you received your package? Have you received your unit?
Supposed to get it either today or tomorrow.
Ah, okay.
It's sitting in LA.
They're sitting in where?
In LA, going through customs.
Oh, get Armand to bring it up.
That's what I sent him a message saying that. Okay, let me share my screen.
Go ahead. For those of you who don't know, Arizona is the first US manufacturing is going into production. We've seen their pictures last week or a couple of weeks ago. And we'll see. They should have their first production next week or two.
Wait, let me get back. Oops. On our automatic, hold on. Okay, so let me do it this way. Can you see your screen? Any of those pictures coming up?
Nope.
Oops. Okay, let me.
No, you have
click
to do your
share. You've got to share the screen.
I tried to. Okay. Share screen. Okay, here we go.
Yep, something's coming up.
Okay, hang on, let me get my
picture. Oh, by the way, you have a beautiful center. It's beautiful. I've seen the pictures of it.
Yeah, I can show a picture of that.
Hang on, I got it.
Okay, great.
Can you see now?
Yes, thank you.
Okay.
Perfect.
Now let me see if I can... I want to go through the slideshow quickly. Okay, let me talk quick. This is our logo. This is the outside of our building. We have over 5,000 square feet in a good area, very good area of Tempe. How do I slow this slideshow down?
Okay. You're seeing pictures.
Okay, I'm trying to slow it down. It's on a slideshow. Okay. Okay, so this is the very first unit that I built. And you can see the connections aren't good. These are some of the other units that we built. These particular units, you can see the salt and stuff. This was one that we built that we put the plasma batteries on, one with the Alex beads. We tried a whole bunch of different stuff. This is one of our later ones where we put, that's what I call a self-generated one. We put it on the bikes to do the electric bikes. We built a universal system, and we built a spaceship. That's Paul in our place. This is our group when Armin came down. We're behind the fire coating system. Again, that's our group. Armin's teaching us. That's what Armin teaches us, kind of like the apple doesn't fall far from the tree. Mr. Keshis. That's Beth sitting behind our desk, our coils that we make. Forgive me the slideshow.
Can I ask a question? How is this nano coating machine which you have?
Tell you the truth, we don't use it.
Why?
Because we find that the pictures the coils aren't true. In other words, everyone is not perfectly round. And when we go from one coil to the next, it's too difficult. There's too much adjustments that have to be made. So we set it aside because we were spending too much time on the programming. So we decided to do things a different way.
Are you using the caustic way?
We're using the caustic way.
Okay. What about your coil making system? Is it working?
The coil making system works excellent. And I'll get to that in 1 minute and you can see how fast it's going. We're making a lot of coils.
Okay, can we have a look, please?
So let me go back to the slideshow. I'm sorry, the slideshow is kind of going kind of quick for me. Oops.
Okay. Hi, John, just open up each picture as you want to display it. That could work as well.
Well, I was trying to do that, but it goes on automatic. Because there's Arma's teachings. Let's see, there's Beth behind the office coil making machine. There's our GANS production area. We have a large facility. We're over 5,500 square feet. That's how we make our coils. Two small, one big. We manufactured with a 3D printer one of these little arming tools. Here's some of the coils that we got ready for production. Those are some of the ones that we burned already. We're not supposed to stack them on each other. Some of those aren't real great. You can see we're going to town with a coil making machine. We've done over 3,000 of them. Let me stop right here. The coil winding machine is going very quickly. Vince, how do I go to these slower?
Just double click on that and then it should open into the picture.
Click on the one picture?
Yep, just double click it.
Okay, here we go.
There you go.
All right.
Now you can move through it as you need to with the arrows at the bottom.
So one of the things that we've done is we've built we're doing a lot of testing right now as we're getting ready for the production. And we've tested a whole bunch of different things. One of the things that we're testing now is our version of the Oasis system. What we did on each of these balls, they're hooked into the fans and they spin in a plastic box, and we've got them all controlled so they all spin together at the same speed. What we put in these is what we call the totality water. The totality water is the water of a bunch of different GANS. The GANS waters that we're using include the basic three that everybody knows about, in addition to brass, gold, lead, and one other one. I forget what else we have. But one of the other things that we did, we created a bucket of totality waters, what we call it. We added what I call the higher strength fields in the universe. And those fields are love and gratitude. So all of the people in our group got together. We sat around this jar of totality water, and we put our energies into it of love and gratitude and peace, so that everything that we generate with the totality water will carry those feels. Now, one of the other things that I did was I put my fields into this too. And let me show you how I did it. I took, these are nano-coated copper cups with a cup of water distilled water. And here on this Q-tip, which is in a plastic bag, on one of them I put my blood, and on one of them I put my lymph. So what I've done is I've put those feels into this water. Okay, so now I have John's lymph, which represents the emotions, and John's blood, which represents the physicality. I put like two drops of each of these into each of those balls, so that each of the balls carry with it that those energies. And the thinking is that what we want to do is create a device that we in this case myself can control with his emotions and control with the physicality. So that's what that's a direction that we're attempting to go. Here again is the same thing. We're actually building another one of these also, a second one, which is going to be a little bit cleaner and nicer. So I don't have a picture of it because we're waiting for these are glass balls on top of here. We're waiting for, we got a glass blower. I'm going to pick those up today. He's blown different sized glass balls for us. So we're going to have those ready to go soon. You can see here, these are actually spinning now. If you look real close, you can see the toroidal fields in the center. We left about 1/8 of the top of it. We didn't fill them completely 100% filled. We put them, you know, like 90% filled. So all of them are generating the toroidal fields. And you can see them interacting with each other. We had this one running for just barely a day now. We tried to run it over the weekend. We had a little bit of problem with a little bit of wobble. We had to get that out of the system. Okay, so one of the other things that we did was when we do the steam caustic, we end up with a bunch of material that we can't use, it's just dirty water, and we don't want to dump it down the drains or create any problems. So we found that we put a vial with CO2, and a copper coil, a nano-coated copper coil into this vial. And when we put it into water, the very next day, all of the sediment settled. So all the caustic materials were moved to the bottom the next day. And I'll show you here. There you can kind of see how it's cleared along the sides. You can see how it's all cleared, and all the caustic materials are sitting on the bottom of the thing. And this goes very fast. Without this thing, without this little device here, the caustic material stays stirred up. In other words, it doesn't relieve itself of the cloudiness. And here you can see it's not a very good picture, but this is a bucket of our caustic material, and it just stays black and cloudy. We're building, this is a device that we're working on now, where we put a coil arrangement inside of a ball. We're going to be spinning this coil one way, and we're going to be spinning the ball another direction. We're going to try to extend this down to put a little loop arrangement all the way through to the bottom to stir up the GANS material that will be in here. There will be GANS, different GANSes inside here. Okay, this is another thing that we're doing. We call this kind of our feeding system. This is a glass cube that we got. These balls are empty right now. These are the plastic balls. We're waiting for the glass balls to come in. We should have those in a day or two. And we're going to fill those with various types of GANs. We put a simple fan motor and a GANs ball right here, which again, we'll fill with probably like a CH3 type of mixture, with CH3 being the giver. And I think that's... There you can see another picture of it. And we got some others that we're building behind it, getting ready. So that's what we're doing. We're really, one of the big things that we're doing is getting ready for the mass production of the units. We're going to have a lot of units and pain pens coming in next week. Mr. Keshe, maybe you can help us with the we need to get those certifications down here, so that we're going to go ahead and try to move forward with the certifications here for the United States. And what we want to do is have those certifications that are already put together, so that we can put them together in a package that we can go to the authorities to have our devices certified in the United States. So if you can help us with that, that would be great. So that's really all I got. Anything else you want to talk about?
No, thank you very much. It's very nice to see this is progress we've seen with the German Keshe Foundation manufacturing as well. While they're waiting for the system or whatever, they keep on developing and testing their ways. The new units, which is going to come out, hopefully be much simpler in production, less labor consuming. But it'll be nice to see the production when it comes online next week or so. The Maglev units will look exactly like the ones we have done here, the white. And the logo of the Keshe Foundation is on it, but the production is US. It's important to realize that it's taken about 6 months to get where we are now, maybe more than 6 months. For the first time this week, we have managed to come to a point that there are no backlogs, no orders outstanding with Maglev units, hopefully with the pads we out this week as well. So it's taken a long time to come to this study point. And it will take a time for you as well to go into production. The advantage you have, you receive the full package. Now you have to make the coil and place them in. And it should be easy from there on. We have placed, I don't know what's the position in US, but we have placed the first purchase order to Iranian manufacturers for the copper coils, which is provided by from the factory directly from Iran. And this will be the same. If you need copper coils in Arizona or any other cash manufacturing around the world, at the rates which we purchase, you just go into the central bank and you ask for it. At the moment, we have 100 ton on order, 20 ton to be shipped next week. It's fantastic. Let me know when you make your first system. It'll be nice to see it, and we'll see where we can go.
Armin will be side by side with us.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Well, thank you very much. I think the next one is Pennsylvania, which is waiting to come on operation. They'll have the same problem as you have. And we'll see where we go. Anything else, or shall we call it a day for today?
I'm wondering if Colleen is able to speak now. She's got a new setup.
Can you hear me?
Yes, hello.
No, I made it work. Yay! Hello, Mr. Cash. This is Colleen, by the way. I had the question about the pearl in my fountain. I can put the video on.
Okay, let's try that.
Yeah. Sorry, I forgot. Before we go on this, we were supposed to see, or we'll do it later on, the machine, the coiling machine, we were supposed to see. Okay, carry on. No problem.
Oh, with John, right?
John, yeah. He said he'll show us the video, but we never saw the video.
Mm-hmm, good point, okay.
This coiling machine is made as part of the Keshe Foundation structure. And we'll see.
Okay, we can see your video there, Colleen.
Okay, I'm trying to hold it up to the fountains.
It's looking sideways right now.
Oh, it's sideways. Okay. Is that right?
Yes, yes. That's better. Okay, we see the fountain.
Okay, and inside, let me get a little light. And
there's an echo, I think, maybe because, well, no, we shouldn't, I guess we can't deal with that. Okay, go ahead, sorry.
And then maybe what I can do is point a little light in here. Can you bring it up higher a little bit? I have an assistant today who's seven, but she can't reach quite up that high. Maybe a little bit. Here, you hold the light. How about that?
There are lots of holes around this place.
Okay, we're starting to be able to zero in there now. Mm-hmm. A bit to the right, please.
Right, is that to the right?
The other right.
The other right.
There.
So, anyway, there are a lot of these little balls in there, little orbs that are forming. And I don't know if you can kind of see where I've got the rose and how I've got, what I've got is a gold-covered rose inside there to make the GANs.
And what is the liquid that the shell is in? The same?
Yes, it's all, what happened was, what was really amazing was, here, I'll stop sharing unless you'd like to see a little bit more of what I've got going on. But these are just some of my Magrav systems, and then there's a sculpture in the background and some art. This is
Colleen, if you turn down your speaker a little bit, it'll come through more clear for us, I think.
Oh, okay. Here's Angela.
It's just there reflecting a bit.
Let me turn off the video. And then come over. But yeah, that was my main question, was just what those little orbs could be. So,
what is orbs?
Spheres or balls, you mean, the little pearls.
Pearls.
But they're fluffy. Did you say they're fluffy, Colleen?
Yes. They're sort of that.
I don't know. I cannot tell you something which I cannot see. And
okay. It could be, someone was saying it could be a, oh, my daughter says they look like little bits of bread. But someone had said that they could be a pearl for me. But I guess we'll find out, huh?
Yeah, you gotta wait a few weeks and see.
Yeah, I'll just let it grow. Thank you, Mr. Cash.
Thank you very much. Do we have anything else? Rick?
I've got a panelist with his hand up that just brought in. We'll see what Dan Hotos. Do you have something there, Dan?
Yes. Hi. Do you hear me?
Yes.
So I can show you my computer mouse who works on the battery for 2 months. And this battery was discharged totally. And for 2 weeks, this battery was charged with the simplest plasma batteries. And now I have the result. The mouse with these batteries worked for 2 months. In the real working process, it was turned on every day. If you want, I can show you this mouse and my result.
Yes, please. Where are you from?
I'm from Ukraine, Kyiv.
Okay.
So I can share my screen with you.
Make sure we don't see anything on your screen, please.
Oh, just now you can see me. I tried to switch camera. Mm-hmm. Can you see my screen now?
Yeah, we can see that.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I can see Rick.
Oh, yes.
Okay, no problem.
So, if you see, this experiment was started at 27th of this year, and this is the date of starting this experiment.
What have you done? Can you explain to us?
Yes, I can explain. So we have this mouse, this little mouse, a Bluetooth mouse. This battery was the standard battery. This battery was used for some time, and it was discharged to the 0.08 volts. So it was discharged totally. Then I have put this battery with a plasma battery of this simplest structure. Yes, I can show the battery I used. 1 second, please. So you can see this one, this unit, battery unit. I was using the one section, not two like here, but the one. It's the simplest way: inner coil, outer coil, aluminum foil, and paper with copper guns.
Separating the inner and the outer core.
Yes, of course.
Okay, yeah.
So what I was done, I just take off this battery. It was here for 2 months. Sorry, 1 second. I take it off. Yes. As I can see to this side of battery, it is leaking now, but it leaks after of 1.5 months of use. So what I was done, I just put the battery between the out and input of plasma battery, and it was staying in this construction for about 2 weeks. And I was seeing how gradually the voltage of battery was increasing. After 16 days of the type of charging, I have a voltage about 0.8 volts in this battery. It was a time when I have a 1 volt, 0.60 volts in that battery after about 17 days of charging with plasma battery. And one day I decided to put this battery back here. And since the day I put it here, my mouse works correctly with no problems about 2 months. Several days, 3 days ago, my computer informed me that mouse was discharged, and I have a result, working mouse about 2 months.
Well, you placed the battery in the position where you showed us originally. You're using it as a normal battery.
Yes, I use it like a normal battery, but it was discharged totally after using, and it was recharged.
How long would the battery last normally in your mouse?
Please.
How long would the mouse go normally?
A month? A mouse goes normally for 2 months of usage.
Okay.
So this is my result.
Are you still charging it?
No. Now I want to do the next step, to do the two battery discharged, recharge two batteries, and place the two battery recharges here. But it was only one battery charged, and this battery, it was normal battery that was bought in the shop.
But is it still charging, or you finished this charge?
I finished the charge, yes.
The battery you made is finished the charge. The one you made.
You speak about that battery?
Yes, the one you made.
Mm-hmm. So you asking me if this battery charging?
Is it still working, or is it stopped? Has it released this charge?
Oh, I do not know. I did not try that. Did not see that. I will try, we'll see, is it working? I think it's working, because I feel that.
Thank you very much. It's in the coming time, the Innovation Center will show new evolution in the power production, hopefully in the next couple of weeks. And we'll see what we can add to the knowledge. It's beautiful. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Rakesh. I have one question about testing the Magrav systems in an official way in the Kiev. I have friends in our technical university, and maybe someday we'll start testing with officials in our country.
Yeah, but make sure when you do, place the unit in a house condition.
Yes, we have one house, and this house is already ready for testing. And I think in coming days we get the result. We get every day meter results. We will.
What power are you using? What load are you using?
Oh, now I have a little heater, about 500 watts in the load side.
That should be about the right, 500. We are running tests here for up and down. We started from 400 to 200 and now to, was it 18 watts? Giovanni is testing. We are testing the other way around, going up from 15 to 100 to find out the trigger point. We think the trigger point of the MagRav system at 50 Hertz, 220 volts, is around about 150 to 200 watt load.
Mm-hmm.
So we start with 200, and after a few weeks, 2-3 weeks, you come down to about 15, 18 watt LED. So we are testing running tests, and yesterday we had the same as you, one of the universities in Italy, and they were here with us, and we are sending them 2 units for them to test too, because this is part of the structure which then it goes to. We need the support of the universities to qualify and specify this, the use of the systems.
Yes.
Let us know, and if you need any help, we are there to support. We have a very good support in Ukraine, and we can support you in any shape or form.
One question I had, if we get official testing with the university, if we can have official certified system for this test, because I can of course do my own system, but I have a little...
Please, we always support this. Give us the address of the university.
Yes, of course.
Send the request to webmaster.
Mm-hmm.
And put on it unit for the university, and then it'll go to Ella, and Ella will send it directly to university. There is no problem.
Thank you very much.
We have no problem with it. We supply to university for testing. If you put the department where you want it to go, mm-hmm. send it to webmaster at spaceshipinstitute.org, and put a subject unit for the university. Give all the details to professor, whatever. We send you from the factory directly, no problem.
Okay, when the documentation will be ready, I contact and we will see what we can do, because I'm sure strongly that young people and students have to know about this technology now. We simply need it now.
It's a matter of how you grow it in the university. We see a number of universities around the world have started because of their students or whatever, testing or looking at different applications.
Mm-hmm.
So, for your unit, send the request to the webmaster, and Ella will organize the shipping. It takes about a week for you to get it.
Okay, thank you very much. And one question about health section, which was interesting to me, it's about dental problems. Had you some cases with dental problems?
A lot of.
Mm-hmm.
Now, in the medical section, Giovanni tells me tomorrow. The doctors tomorrow, the doctor's teaching. Oh, professor of dental. Thank you. No problem. Mm-hmm. Yes, depends what the question is and what it's for.
Mm-hmm.
The we have set up now the doctors at keshfoundation.org or doctors at the spaceshipinstitute.org. The progress of learning and teaching each other carries on Wednesday afternoons at 2 o'clock. If you're a doctor or you have to have a certified working doctor, you send your request to doctors@keshefoundation.org or spaceshipinstitute.org, and you'll be given access to these learning sessions. It's especially for them. We have separated the military space teaching, and we have separated the doctor's teaching. And the military will go now in a totally different way. We process, we teach. But the medical, doctors, health teaching, dentists, Wednesdays between 2 and 5 o'clock is a live cases the doctors bring on. And now we have appointed a person who will look after all the data from all the trials, all the testimonials you have. If you put on the Keshe Foundation, cancer@keshefoundation.org, health@keshefoundation.org, if I'm correct, the webmaster tell us. Post it anywhere, send it to us. Now we have a person responsible for categorizing testimonials for doctors and health authorities. She starts this week, and most of you know her. She will separate and categorize every application, what you used, what was used by the doctors, and what can be certified with. So if you have anything to do, it's got to do with dental, we go send the people, dentists, to doctors@keshefoundation.org, and we look into it.
Okay, thank you very much.
I give you a small tip, and I've done this before, just remind for those of you, if you have any gum, more or less gum problems or denture, dentist, dental problem, you can, especially for youngsters, you can keep and everything intact without the need to go too much to the dentist. Just by taking a block of cheese every night before you go to sleep. It'll do miracles. Even the cavities are known to be reversing. Even if you have a gum, what do you call it, problems, it works, miracles. Small piece of cheese at night before, two or three times a week. It creates a lot, especially for youngsters, which they have a tooth decay problem, you will see everything will change.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you very much. See you next time. Please let us know more.
Yes.
And don't forget, get in touch with Webmaster, we'll send the unit directly to university.
Okay, we'll try to do this.
Okay. Meanwhile, I have to thank the people who are and connected to Bulgarian universities. Thank you for your invitations and collaboration. And the same goes with the Italian universities and Chinese organizations. If you want the support or in any shape or form development, we are open to discuss and teach and learn from you. Anything else, or shall we end the day?
Mr. Keshe, there was a message from I got from Sylvester regarding a comment from Dave Stewart. He says, "This is Dave."
Pardon?
About Dave Stewart, and he Who's says. Dave? Dave says, this is Dave from Peru. I have a friend working with the beginning of the Keshe Foundation Peru on Magravs, and he's had a terrible fall and shattered his skull 8 weeks ago, and would like to ask Mr. Keshe if he can offer help. Do you think this is a good time? Perhaps Dave Stewart could come on and speak a bit.
We have heard this request, we are not there, we do not know the condition, and it needs to, we heard this. So first of all, the first 4 to 6 weeks of accident, especially head injury, you cannot get involved with. And secondly, we need to understand what it is, the condition, that if it's in coma, what has caused, if it's an intrusion with the bone, or is it what kind of condition is. And then we have to have doctors who can collaborate with us. Then there is a way we can help where we got to see MRIs. You can send the documents to doctors@keshefoundation.org. We leave it to the doctors if any of them wants to pick it up. And we look at it, we are prepared to, I know about this case, many emails I've received. And I said from the beginning, the first 4-6 weeks minimum, we cannot interfere because we have to understand the condition. After that, we're in collaboration with the doctors, especially with the head injury, if it's in a coma condition, or what is settled down to. If it's a bone has what do you call it, embedded in the tissue of the brain. You have to look at everything, and then we advise the doctors, and then they decide if to carry on with what the advice is. We need to see all the details. I know about this case, I've been bombarded with this for past 6-8 weeks. I said, we don't take position, we don't advise anything till we know. Now it's 8 weeks or so, then we have to have a doctor in Peru who can, who is, understand the technology and can collaborate with us. And then we have to look at it. We bring it on the table most probably tomorrow, if it comes, or next week with the doctors. We'll discuss it with the doctors and see how we can advise with the full understanding of the doctors in Peru and the team of doctors we work here with on the teaching side. We've taken a stand, especially on the health side, to stay very clean and clear in this respect. Everything will be done by the doctors. We do not need to get involved in what I call the health section with other doctors. We have enough support around the world with medical people that gradually they join and they increase the knowledge. This is one of the interesting points which we have seen. And as you are aware, in Belgium, they tried very hard to clamp us down with the practicing medicine, which they did not do. Now they changed the wind in a different direction. We are monitoring the case, and I have an announcement to make. Keshe Foundation closes all activities in Belgium within the next 14 days. We close all our operations because we had had enough of terrorism by the what you call the people who live in Antwerp and the rest, and the Germans. So as now we have different organizations around the world, we transfer all the activities of Keshe Foundation out of Belgium, then this is a loss to the nation. We contributed hundreds of thousands of euros to Belgium taxation and BTV, and they caused a loss. The income for the country has gone for the Keshe Foundation. We're closing Keshe Foundation PowerCell, Keshe Foundation Research and Development, and Keshe Foundation Belgium. Not as a protest, but to keep the Keshe Foundation out of the hand of what are called terrorists in their country and the police force and the rest of it. We have already informed the authorities that we're closing out all activities. We will not produce, we will not operate, and we stay out of that country till the court case in respect to the King of Belgium, the police force in Kortrijk, is settled by the International Court of Justice and the courts in Italy. The harassment has gone beyond the limit, so we have withdrawn out of the country, and in so many ways, once we have the settlement with the courts in respect to the police force, especially in Kortrijk, with the officer, Mr. the gentleman who knows who he is, he's still harassing people around Belgium, threatening them to prison, and the rest is all getting on a back-to-back checked by the Interpol. So you will see, we'll give you a new address, new bank system in all the activities of Keshe Foundation. And as of 31st of this month, the Keshe Foundation closes all activities in Belgium. We close our books on a clean base. And in a way, the country lost hundreds of thousands of euros income because of the fraudulent activities of what we call the Red Circle and the rest. If the nation can lose in this kind of unemployment and the losses of huge income of BTV and others, now we have given you the good news. You can stay in your nation and wash your own dirt with your own people. Thank you very much indeed. We go ahead with the teaching on Thursday, and at the same time, we'll bring a new insight in the development of the technology in number of countries which are developing different aspects of technology. We have seen, and we will introduce, a new process with disinfection for public. A lot of you who are in that game, you can market it, produce it, and let us know. You do not need to use different chemicals. There is a new structure which comes into operation. You can use it as a detergent, more or less, but it's against detergent. And we'll introduce new systems for what we call health applications. Thank you very much indeed for your work. Thank you for sharing knowledge. And I would like to thank again the group of seven who sit in the background. We received your message and we'll respond to you accordingly. Thank you very much indeed. See you. A seminar on cache plasma technology by Dr. Rodrigo. Oh yes, Dr. Rodrigo, he's with us tomorrow. Thank you very much indeed. Thanks for your time.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Keshe. Once again, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay, that'll wrap it up for today's workshop, the 16th International Knowledge Seekers Workshop of the Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute. And that's for May 24th, 2016. And as ever, thank you everybody for attending. Okay, I'll end the live stream now.